Hello, I hope you guys get this message. We're coming to you live from the Spiritual Revolution. As you can tell, it's pretty static here in this bunkhouse. We're undercover at the moment. The rest of the troops went out on a little recon mission, so I'm here now alone in the bunker, the hidden hideout of some of the people that are at the fore of the Spiritual Revolution. What are they called? The insurgents. Now, as you can tell, there's some devotional music in the background, so it's a little loud here. So just bear with me. I'm going to show you around what's going on in the sense of people doing crazy shit. They're committing everything to the oneness and the belief that love is the only thing that's real in this world and that has any value. So anything that's not part of the oneness, as you can see behind me, there's a lot of work happening. I think this is some kind of a, I can't really point with this device I have, but this is some kind of altar to the Divine Mother, to the Goddess. And as you can see, there's really, these folks are really focusing on the integration of the masculine and feminine. I don't know what that's about. If you look around behind me, there's all kinds of various images from all different traditions. Now, some people will say that there's appropriation happening here. And apparently these rebels, these forces of radical change in the spiritual dimension, they don't give a F. And this is their own words. They don't give a F about cultural appropriation and political correctness. Because as far as they could tell, the only thing that's a priority for humanity is love unconditional. So we're really looking at some radical stuff here. So I don't know how much you guys could take in back there. But there's, good Lord, there's... interpretations of divinity of all kinds from all traditions. If I could just turn the camera around here, how do I do that? Well, I just bear with me. I know it's a little shaky, but behind me you'll see an image of I believe that's Jesus Christ. And these people don't necessarily even think the historical Jesus. I mean, he was probably great. He was probably really saintly, but they think that the Christ consciousness just lives inside of everyone. So as you can see, this is. They're really trying to break things up in terms of hierarchy and stuff like that, and really just kind of see people as equals and how they all have the divine in them. So again, there's the goddess altar you can see. I didn't have time, but I was going to find a Sharpie, and most of the people in this community, they tattoo a question mark on their foreheads as a reminder that they don't know anything. And that's so counter to most of the culture where we need answers and we need to get to the bottom of stuff. These beings believe that they don't know, and they believe that the mysterious approach is the ultimate way to happiness, to just surrender and be grateful for this amazing miracle of life that we have. So by the time they come back, I'm going to find a Sharpie, put a little question mark on my forehead, and I'm going to send this out as soon as possible. So I hope it gets to you guys, and wish me luck. The Kirtan track is ending soon, so they'll be back. All right, all the best to all you folks out there, and listen, if you want to not get brainwashed by this kind of a thing, don't think for yourself, and just spend a lot of time on big media. That's all I guess all I got for now. All the best, and bye.